Hello, 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 welcome back to the Flyer. Oh, look at that finger. It's in the gym. Like a blood blister. Fucking disgusting. And please like, comment, share, subscribe if you did enjoy it or didn't enjoy it. I just want to get this channel going. Create more conversations or make some more enjoyable videos. So this movie is called Penguin Bloom. This was the second film I watched that night of the viewing. Just double check so I can look at the way I go. That feels a bit moved down. I got it. So Penguin Bloom is a 2020 drama. It goes for 1 hour and 35 minutes. It came out on the 21st of January 2021 in Australia. So the premise of the movie is a photographer and his family find hope and solace in an injured magpie chick. I didn't watch it, as I said in the previous video, if you didn't watch it, about Dawn Raid, remember that was the title? I didn't watch the trailer, I didn't know what the fuck this movie was about, never heard of it before, and afterwards I realised, I was told actually, it was a based on a true story, which is pretty fucking cool. Right. Penguin Bloom, where do I begin? The start of the movie kind of didn't grip me. A little bit all over the place. It was being told from a child's perspective. See the whole fall off. Again, this is spoilers. I don't think spoilers are reviews because I'm lazy and can't be fucked, and I find them boring myself. So it is what it is. The mother falls off. You find out why and how she fell off and became disabled. You see her struggling with her disability, her mental struggles. The family dynamic struggles, her husband, the living struggles and the struggles, and her husband and their relationship together, and the relationship with the children. And I really, really did enjoy seeing how the family dealt with the mother's disability, how the husband himself dealt with the disability, how he took care of her, he was struggling with taking care of the kids, still not working, struggling to know what to do around her, and how to be, to ask, how is your day, because you're fucking treated by that. I said, don't ever fucking ask me that in front of the kids. Because every day I'm suffering in pain and I'm not okay. And life is not good. I can't fucking walk. I'm stuck in a wheelchair. I can't even get myself out of bed. I can't wash myself. I can't do anything for myself. Which is fair enough. It could be hard to lose your ability to do all the things that you love, like surfing and walking on the beach. So I really, 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 really enjoy the family dynamics. And I think they hit it out of the park. They did it to a perfect amount where you felt something emotional, but didn't feel too depressed about life or too cynical. They balanced it really, really well. So the reason it's called Penguin Bloom is because they find a magpie, black and white, and it's called Penguin. The main child of the film finds the penguin and finds I thought Penguin, because that's in my head, but it's a magpie. I thought it would have been more interesting if I actually found Penguin, but anyway, she's the rest of it, but I think that's true to itself. The penguin, it is unable to fly, it's quite sick, I think, or disabled, whatever it is. It's a baby bird, lost its family, that's what it was. So the child brings it home, feeds it, bathes it, cleans it, and the family decide to keep it. The penguin is unable to fly, so I feel like the mother at first didn't like Penguin, but because Penguin was disabled, I guess she felt a special bond towards Penguin and connected to it, and gave her, I guess, a sense of purpose and a sense of responsibility and something to do day to day. It's quite nice. If someone is, I guess, struggling with something and they have a sense of purpose and a sense of direction and a sense of feeling like they're worthy of, like, life is worth living and not living to get out of bed and have to do something. Push them take the kids to school anymore. There's a scene where the son was vomiting in the bed, in the toilet, and screams out, Dad, help me, and she's particularly sad that he used to call mine. She's really upset and crying. That's what he used to call me. Now they call for you, and she didn't know how to deal with that, and she realized that she isn't able to help her children, and they're vulnerable and in need. children in that direction, and not to call for the father, she's not on the agenda or list anymore, which is fucking disheartening. Having what your priest meant to be taken away from you, a sense of responsibility. Children not calling you. It'd be hard to deal with. I can't imagine what she was going to do. Presented it, as I said, really, really well. So Penguin took care of it throughout the movie. It was kind of done well the way it was visually, how they visually presented it, and too fake or too out there. The dynamic of the mother was quite interesting, with the mother's mother, so the grandmother of the children, how she felt really bad for something sad. And she blamed the husband, what occurred, and blamed the daughter for going on a trip to Thailand, because it actually happened. Her character herself, I didn't think it was necessary, I didn't like it too much, grandmother, but she was disturbed and it is what it is, could accept it. Like the dynamic, I do call that a shift today. Like the dynamic between the mother and the child, the mother that was disabled and the child that was on the roof, and she fell off the roof. How the child felt like the mum. The child felt responsible for what happened to the mother and felt like the mother blamed them for the accident, which is half true. The mother didn't look at the child with love anymore, was quite a bit of disgust, a bit of fuck you kind of thing, but just to me. The mentality, never hugged it, never kissed it. Quite the information, but the boys always just feel progressed instead of having more getting more intimate. And she even said, I think it specifically, I don't remember, but she said it was out, so it was both went on the roof. Which was good to see. And hit an emotional tone, but to me, the same, it was our choice, kind of takes a bit of responsibility to kid to, and if there's anything better to say, it was my choice to go on with, because at the end of the day, we are all responsible for our own body and our own decisions. So it's going to be a good thing. What I didn't like about the film, I found it cringy how they were cheering for Penguin when it first flew. I'm like, Penguin, go Penguin, go Penguin, yeah. It just felt really weird and poorly done and poor acting. It didn't feel genuine or real. I was watching it laughing at how fucking dumb it looked and how stupid it was. So it really, really took me out of the movie and didn't enjoy it. The other scene I didn't like when Penny was attacked by the other bad guys. And that scene again took me out of it. It was dramatic. We're trying to be dramatic and trying to be vindictive and evil. But it didn't come across in that movie. It came out goofy and cheesy and cringe. Those two scenes with Penguin were fucking terrible and trash. All the scenes with the human were amazing and perfect and well done. No complaints about any of the scenes with the humans, but the main issue with the film is with Penguin itself. And some of the scenes involved. So the human acting during the scenes with these specific ones with Penguin were terrible. So I guess it is also critical of the humans, but I'm focusing on Penguin. Because that was the main focus point of the film. In those specific scenes. So the scene where Metcalf's attacking it, and the scene where Penguin was flying for the first time. It's really, really goofy as fuck. One of my favourite fucking actors in the film was the New Zealand lady. I forget her name. I don't find it, sorry. Let me see it. Rachel House, she plays the character of Gay. She's fucking hilarious. I love her and everything she does. I've seen her in, what has she done? She has done Hunt for the Builder People. Amazing fucking movie. She's in Thor Ragnarok, Momoa. Eagle vs. Shark. Amazing fucking film too. Soul. Boy. Now. The only films I've seen with her from memory. But everything she's in, Rachel, Meredith, that's how you pronounce it, but she's a New Zealand actress. She was my favourite thing in this. She's hilarious. She played a kayaking, I think it's called, kayaking supervisor or teacher. And she taught the main lady in the film. The character's name is Ramon. Oh, Sam Bloom. So Sam Bloom is played by Naomi Watts. But yeah, Sam is disabled. The husband suggests that, you know, how about you? You love water, how about you pack? You don't need electric packs. But eventually she goes in the thing and she fucking loves it. And this one, teacher, Rachel, is called Gay. And she's good comic relief for such a depressing and serious film, and for a lot of it, an emotional film, a heavy film. And there's one scene specifically where the first time in the war, she's together still, I don't know something like that. And then the other scene where they're having dinner with the family and the mother's fucking grilling the Sam. And they go, oh, this is a bit more fun, I'm going to get up and leave. Like, no. Okay. I'm going to get up and leave. Like, no. Okay. But yeah, she's fucking amazing. Rachel. So if you haven't seen Pamela Bloom, I do recommend you see it. If you haven't seen any of the Hassis films, go out and see them. She's amazing in all of them. She's the best actress. Yeah, it's like Pamela. She's really, really good. So this film itself, I'm going to review, because I'm around at this point, and it's really too long. The rating on this film, I'm going to give it, is a 7.75 out of 10. The main reason for this score is 1, it was fucking amazing. 2, acting was on point. 3, I didn't like a lot of the score, so that's about 1 point for me. Didn't like the score itself, a lot of the scenes, didn't quite fit the tone of the movie. I didn't like the acting scene. I mentioned the previously significantly. It really, really took me out of the movie and quite ruined it for me. The one with Penguin and the Magpie being attacking it, and the scene where Penguin's flying for the first time and I'm feeling that kind of really. So that's the main reason for the loss of points. Overall, solid. I do recommend you go out and see it. I won't really watch it. Something that's movies for me. But yeah, peace out guys. Love you all. Like, comment, subscribe if you enjoyed. And I'll see you guys in the next motherfucking video. Peace out. Bye.